Hey guys, it's Lee here from Andertons TV, and we are at NAMM 2020 on the Dingwall Basses booth, and I'm here with Sheldon Dingwall.
Hey everybody.
So, there's a couple of new basses that we can look at, but as a guitar player myself rather than a bass player, I'm slightly fascinated with why. What is it about your basses that have captured the imagination? Because they're pretty, like, they don't really conform to a traditional design, and they've been unbelievably popular. So what's the magic ingredient?
You know, I'll admit I'm a guitar player too. and that was part of the secret to being successful in basses, because I had an outsider's perspective on bass. And so when people kept coming to me and asking for a bass with a better B string, more balanced string tension, and something that fit into the mix better, I had no idea what to do. So I came from a piano background.
Okay.
And multi-scale's not new. Multi-scale has been around since 3000 BC. And we've only seen it in the harp and piano family, and it's worked beautifully for that family of string instruments. And it's only recently that it's come over to the guitars and basses. And the reason it works so well is because this is the way to get strings to be even tension, right, and even tonality. And that makes all the differences in terms of fitting into the mix.
When you say it like that, it is bizarre, because I'm literally in my head, even going back to certainly pianos, but like old lutes and it is all just, the strings never had the same scale length.
It's always been there. It's been hidden in plain sight.
Well, so tell me, maybe there's one or two new ones, or maybe the some of the best-selling ones, and just give people a quick overview of what's coming.
Far and away, the best-selling bass in our line is the NG model, and that stands for Nolly Getgood. And, he's a local UK boy, and I hope you're proud of him, because I'm super proud of him. He's one of the most brilliant musicians I've ever come across, and just a sweetheart of a guy. And so, the new colors.
Wow.
This just won Best Bass of 2019.
Did it? Congratulations.
In Latin America.
Amazing.
And Adam was a big part of it. Dark Glass was a big part of it. And the Dark Glass preamp, the tone capsule, actually, the concept of that was hashed out in Disneyland. We're all sitting at a table, and we came up with the idea for the preamp together. But I think it's funny that a preamp that has been so adopted by the heavy world,
yep,
started in Disneyland.
Yeah. It's a great looking bass. Love that gold color. That's awesome. What else have we got?
Well, we have a model called the D-Bird. And as of NAMM show last year, we changed it up slightly, and it's now the D-Rock.
Okay.
And so that allowed us a little bit of freedom to make it look more like our own bass.
Yeah, so I can see you can see the nod towards the Thunderbird kind of vibe,
exactly,
can't you? It's with the graphic, it's cool, but it is its own thing. So this is one of the existing models, right?
Existing, this is the first in the standard lineup in the five string.
Oh, right, okay,
so we
cool.
started out with the four string. I didn't want to try the five string first because balance is a real issue,
yep,
and a real challenge on that body shape to get the whole thing to balance on a strap well. And so we figured that out on the four string.
Massively smaller headstock than the Thunderbird, isn't it?
Exactly.
That's trying to stop that neck dive thing.
The neck dive, and also the strap pins on the back, you can see how they've been moved in and towards the neck. And that does two things. It allows the bass to hang perfectly on the strap.
Yeah.
And it also moves the bass this way.
Right.
And I mean, that's a 37 inch scale, but your arm never has to reach very far for it.
Yeah. I'm loving this green sparkle one just over your shoulder.
Is that rock and roll or what?
That is bold. On the sparkle color as well, it's easier to see the raised center bit as well. I kind of almost missed it on the burst one, because of the shadow almost looks like it's part of the burst, whereas I can see that the bigger center block.
Well, the original Thunderbird was designed by a car designer, and so we reimagined it as if that car designer was looking through the lens of a Lamborghini. So if you look at the contours, it's got nice round muscular contours. The back has a tummy cut that's super deep. It just pulls the bass in, and it's just a really comfortable feeling bass. Super lightweight too.
Who wouldn't want a bass inspired by a Lamborghini? That's cool. Anything new on the other side of the booth?
There sure is, yeah.
This is a stunning looking bass. Tell me a little bit more about this.
Well, I'm a huge car fan, and last year, Southern California has some amazing Bentleys and Rolls's, and when you drive down to Newport Beach, they're everywhere. And so I saw this Bentley with this crazy red finish, and I went, man, that's as badass as you can get. And I look inside, and it's got a beautiful Macassar Ebony dash all the way around, and I went, I'll never be able to afford that, but I can build one. And so this is my ode to that sexy Bentley that I saw. The ghost inlays are new for us this year, and that kind of mimics the trim around the speedometers and the dash. And as with all Dingwalls, the battery change is super easy. There's a third strap in on the back, which shifts the center of gravity over, again, to make that neck manageable. So
I've not seen this. Can you flip it? I've not seen this strap pin idea. So is that there's like a pin that stays on the strap, is there, and just plugs into the socket?
Dunlop strap locks, they plug in here, or if you move it around, it just plugs in back there, and it really makes the bass hang beautifully, especially if you've got less reach or you've got shoulder problems. It solves all that.
I love the look of it. I mean, I have to be honest, you are killing it with some of the color. Look at that as well. I'm really, oh man.
This is a Lee Sklar model, and check out the size of those frets.
Oh, wow, they're minuscule. It's like razor wire.
Yeah, 25 years ago, I sent Lee his first bass, and he said, oh man, it's perfect. I forgot to tell you, I like mandolin frets on my bass. And I thought, mandolin frets? Well, you're Lee Sklar, I'll put them on. And it's one of those moments that was just, I will never forget it. The feel is just absolutely amazing. When you slide your finger, it's almost like a fretless.
What is it about his playing style that you think, is it just a very light touch kind of playing style?
He keeps changing his style because he's been playing, I mean, he's been on well over 2,000 albums, well over 20,000 songs. So he's had an extremely long career, and he keeps playing his changing style as he ages, and you know, new aches and pains start, so he'll change how he holds things. He's just got a very fluid, it just fits into, he never tries to show off, he never tries to stand out in the music. He's a complete supportive artist, and he's just the perfect bass player.
The Hellboy graphic, I think, is amazing. Is that inspired by the Hellboy kind of comics?
It's licensed by the artist. And there's something subtle going on here in the electronics. We call it Tone 2.0.
Okay.
So the passive system goes straight from the master volume, rotary pickup selector, and then out. And then there's a drive circuit that runs parallel to that. And it doesn't really increase the volume. It just adds saturation. And the difference in making that fit into the mix is mind-blowing. You can have anywhere from just the slight warm breakup of a SVT, dime the controls and it sounds like a buzzsaw, or anywhere in between. And kind of the sweet spot is sort of halfway between those two.
This is fantastic. I love the look of it. So yeah, sorry, anything else new before we wrap things up?
Just new colors, and I got to tell you, we're super happy to be with you guys. When I toured your store, I couldn't believe the family atmosphere.
Yeah.
And all the work and effort you've put into making the lives of musicians so much easier and the purchase process so much easier. You've really done a great job.
I appreciate that. And I have to say, credit to my colleague Stuart, who doesn't like being in front of camera because every time he is, everyone thinks he's my dad, despite the fact that he's only about 4 years older than me. But he's a massive bass fan, and he's really reinvigorated Andertons as a bass dealer over the last 4 or 5 years. And likewise back to you, I'm super, super happy that you've allowed Andertons to sell your basses, because I know it's a really exclusive line, and there's not a lot of basses being made, so I'm super happy as well. I have to ask you one last thing.
Sure.
Now that I know you're a guitar player, why no guitars then? Is there not like a Dingwall guitar idea?
Well, oh yeah. Yeah, I've got tons of ideas. And to give you the entire history and shrunk down to a sentence, we had a fire that consumed the entire shop in 96.
Wow.
And at that time, the basses were taking off like a rocket. And so I thought, okay, we'll tool up the basses, and in 6 months, we'll do the guitars. And the basses just kept taking off and kept taking off. We have a 2-year back order waiting list on the custom shop and about a year waiting list on all the production instruments. Amazing. We just don't have time to build guitars, you know?
Well, at least we know now. Hey, look, bass players need some love, man, and you're giving it to them, so good luck. Anyway, see you soon. Happy NAMM. See you in the next video.
Cheers.